So if you've ever shot through a window, you would have seen a bunch of reflections and you'll realize how hard it is to get rid of them. And some of them, it almost looks impossible, but there's some new technology from Adobe that I want to share with you right now. And I witnessed this at Adobe Max. Every year at Adobe Max, they have a segment called Sneaks. And these sneaks are where the engineers show some of the craziest technology that they're working on. Some of these will make it into real products and some of them won't. This one looks like it was based inside of Lightroom. Now, there's no guarantee this will actually ship in Lightroom, but I sure hope it does. Let's have a look and see what it does. So the engineer Eric Key calls this one Project See-Through. The previous example wasn't that exciting, so let's start with the one of the dog. If we look at this dog, look at all the reflections around it. Then he applies this AI tool inside of Lightroom Classic. Let's watch.
So let's try cleaning this one up too. Boom, reflections are gone. Whoa. The AI has automatically pulled all of those trees out of the background and on the face of the dog, right? This is definitely much more of the photo that I was looking for.
All right, so if we examine this photograph, look how it's added a lot of contrast here to the plant, to the leaves, and also to the animal, to the dog. It's definitely given it a punch of contrast in the whole image, as well as reducing the reflections. Now, I'm not sure what the details are going to be like close up, but this is pretty good. But then he goes on to this even more difficult example, and he shows how he can separate the reflections from the photos. So let's have a look at this.
Something else too. This time let's also save the reflection.
Notice he's choosing an option called Reflection Removal Options, Save Reflection.
Reflections are gone.
So when we see this example here, it's quite remarkable. It's really got rid of the reflections and using AI, probably some kind of generative fill here, to fill everything in, but it just looks really accurate. What's surprising for me is how it's able to get rid of the reflections on the glass without affecting the reflections on things like the turntable and some of these glass areas inside the image.
And don't forget, we saved the reflection. So here's that.
Cool.
Okay, and as you can hear, the crowd went crazy because it saved out a separate image for the reflection. Now, this is not really a usable image on its own. However, if you wanted to just reduce the reflection effect, you could apply this inside of Photoshop and drop the opacity, or you could even go to other photos where you wanted to simulate some kind of a reflection, pop this reflection in there and add it when you want to put your own glass in. And then we're going to look at one more example that he did.
Reflection covers about half of the photo, but it's also really strong. Up here in the sky, you can barely see anything through that, but let's try it anyway.
Wow.
Reflections are gone.
So if we look here, it looks like it's captured everything really, really well. So if you look on the left one, notice this whole side is gone. The sky is completely blowing out this ceiling area, but yet it's been able to recreate it. Okay, so this is an experimental feature, but I find it quite encouraging that he showed this within Lightroom Classic. In previous years, they showed dehaze, and within a year, that was made it into the mainstream Lightroom and Camera Raw. And this is something I just find incredibly useful for things like shooting out of airplanes. I always get the reflection on the window, or even hotels. I love to stay on a high floor and take photographs of the city, but there's always those reflections in the way. Even when you turn off all the lights and put a blanket around the camera, sometimes you still get those reflections. So even people on tours on things like buses and trains, taking pictures out the windows, if this technology makes it into Lightroom and Camera Raw, this could be a game changer where we can actually save those photos and use photos that previously we wouldn't be able to. I'm interested in your thoughts. Let me know in the comments underneath if you would use this, if it would become an actual real feature. And by the way, if you want to know the new features in Lightroom, check out my other video here. If you're new to Photoshop Cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.